Hello, everybody. I'm Janet Mae Spriggins Harris, the only daughter of Clement, the seventh child of Clement and Lola Thompson. I have fond memories of when I was growing up in Mississippi. We stayed in Florida until I was five, and then we moved to the big city of Jackson. During that time, we would always spend summers and holidays with the grandparents. We called them Mama Lola and Papa. Papa, I remember, was blind, and the only thing I can remember by him is seeing his big legs inside high-top shoes. I don't remember his face at all. But as for Mama Lola, she lived with us when we came to Jackson. She would come to visit. And I remember talking to her about our ancestors, and she told her that her mother's name was Ellen Powell. So I can go from Lola Champion all the way up to Ellen Powell. And I have two siblings, Leo in New Orleans and Apple, who lives here in Jackson. And that's about it.
My name is George Vaughn. I'm the son of Willie Thompson Vaughn. She had only one child. I grew up in the town of Florida. Now I want to tell you one thing. Make sure in life you have more than one child. Because one child lives a longer life. You ain't got nobody to play with, nobody to talk with. You find the child end up and be an adult. We lived on a plantation. I worked in the field. My daddy didn't like the hoe, so I didn't do much flying. I did all home. I went to school quite a bit. In fact, my mother said she wasn't raising no plowboy. She was raising a different person. So I went to school and I was not a plowboy. I learned how to read and write. But I want to tell you one thing, getting an education in my day and time was a rough thing. It wasn't the white folks that didn't want you to go to school. It was your own black folks. Everybody said Tim and Willie ought to have that boy in the field. While I was in school, they said I ought to have been in the field. So I went to school. I was the first male to graduate from high school living on a plantation, on the Wilson Plantation. I finished high school in 1957. I went to Tougaloochee Mill. I stopped and I worked at Presto, Harrison Drugstore, and finally Biggerson Cooperative. 1970, I started pastoring my kinfolk. You ain't pastored nobody until you deal with kinfolk. I stayed at Livingston 9.5 years. Those years taught me how to pastor anywhere in the world. I have 7 children, 5 boys, and 2 girls, 15 grand and 6 great grand. Those are the descendants of Tim and William A. Vaughn. I hope all of you will recognize one thing as Tony. Make sure you have more than one child.
I am the third daughter of Lily Mae and Jane Thompson. And my name is Louise Lowe. And I have 10 siblings. And one of 3 boys and 7 girls. Their name is number 1, Annie Mae Lawson. Number 2, Carrie Bell McElroy Smith. My name is Louise Thompson Lowell. Maggie Tyler. in Maddie V. Beamer, in Lucia Cooper, Corrine Bolton, Willie Lee Thompson, Mo Thompson, and Dane Thompson Jr. They have 47 grandkids. And my sister, I have two sisters live in Michigan. One of my sisters, which is Maggie Tyler, is dead. I have one sister live in Chicago, Illinois, that's Lucia Cooper. And Corey Bowler lived in Natchez. Maddie Beamer is deceased, and James Thompson Jr. is deceased. I'm a retired nurse, surgical technician. I've worked in the operating room with the doctors. And, but now I'm retired and I'm really enjoying life. I have five children. I have four of my grandkids is here today with me. And I have a granddaughter that lives in Memphis. And my other daughter is a manager at Cook and Love. And my oldest daughter works at University Medical Center. She's a nurse. She also hires nurses at university. I really have enjoyed myself here today. And I mostly know everybody here, but sometimes I have problems with remember names, but their face is always there.
Hi, everyone. We are the siblings of John and Alice Thompson. We grew up in Fort, Mississippi. We was farmers, and we grew our own crops, and we have what we call truck patches, and we even grew our own popcorn. We had cucumbers, watermelons. So my daddy was a master farmer. And our main income at that time when we were small were producing cotton. And now this is not all of us, it's several of us missing, but this is the majority. Together, John and Alice had 14 children, and as of today, 13 siblings are still living. We all attended the East Flora High School in Flora, Mississippi, and we went to various colleges as we grew older. I graduated from Tougaloo. I have other siblings who graduated from Jackson State, some from business school, and Hines General College, William Carey College. My oldest sibling, he's residing in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and he's not with us today. We grew up attending the Livingston Missionary Baptist Church, and the majority of us, the siblings, still attend that church today. So let my sibling introduce themselves to you, starting from my left.
Philip Thompson.
Alice Lyle.
Ford Thompson.
Diddy Thompson.
Wesley Thompson. Brian Thompson.
Andy Thompson. Grant
Thompson. Leslie Thompson.
And I'm the youngest of the family, and I'm Maria Thompson.
And yours truly is Lloydstein Thompson Worthy.
Hi. We are four of the children of Ametha Thompson, Mary Joseph Brand. There were 10 of us in all. Name this: L.C., Martha, Josenelle, Dolores, Jonathan, John Honest, Curly Edward, Sylvester, Margaretta, and Anthony. Is that all of us? We grew up on the farm. We were close-knit family. We grew up, some moved away, but most stayed around home. So, here we are at the family reunion, joining friends with the rest of the family. Hello, everybody.
My name is Felix Thompson. My brothers are Jordan, Cleo, Anthony, Quentin, and Sharon, to see this together. Two sisters, Jacqueline and Doris. We are the children of Cleo Thompson and Sadie Thompson. Raised in Flora, Mississippi, eventually moved to Jackson, was raised in a church, in Livingston M.B. Baptist Church, pastored by Reverend Vaughn, which is our cousin, and moved all had our careers and moved to Jackson, and that's about it.
I came up in the field. We had to wait when we came up. We came up back in the hard time. It was hard time. And we came up in the field. I had to pick cotton. We had to get cool a lot of time. I had to get cool because we didn't have no money. We didn't have no shoes or nothing. So we had to work. I had to work to help my dad out. And my dad had come up on the phone, but I knew I wasn't gonna work on the phone when I got out there. After I got out, I wasn't gonna work for the white man. So, you know, when I got out of school, I was just trying to get a factory job. Then that's where we're going then. Factory, that's where we're going at that particular time. And so, you know, that was the end of working in the field, all that stuff. I got out of that stuff. But with mama, she worked hard, and they set up the church. We went to church every Sunday. But my mama and dad, they just went twice a month. But they set up every Sunday. So I served in the church. I was the Sunday crew superintendent one time. And I served in the choir. And now I'm a trustee now at Living Baptist Church. And so I'm still in the church. And most of us still in the church. We come up in the church. We come in our Christian home. That's about it.
All right, so we're going to start with the generation of S.E. Spriggins and Clement Thompson. This is the daughter of S.E. Spriggins and Clement Thompson, Johnny May. We are the two sons of Johnny May, Bobby and Edward. And this is the wife of Bobby. This is Kiana. And this is little Claire Noel. So again, we are descendants of Clement Thompson. And we're here at the Thompson Family Reunion, here to give love, to be thankful, to continue to fellowship with family. In God we trust, because we know God is love, love is family. So we just come to fellowship because we all live in different places.
Yep.
New Orleans, St. Louis, St. Louis, and New York. And we are here, again, just to fellowship with the Thompson family because it's so much love and we all eat and love to eat. There's so many wonderful cooks in our family, and we just really appreciate the ability to spend time with our phenomenal family. As we say, not quite. So as I end, I simply say, I divinely respect you. That's what we say in my ministry back in New York. So we thank you for sharing this time with us as we bid you adieu. Everybody wave. All right, thank you very much.
I never heard of something.
My name is Thompson.
We are descendants of Alice Thompson and John Thompson.
Today we are at the 2016 Family Reunion. We're here live with our family, friends. We're gathered together to show love and joy and peace to show that our family is still together and we're still here. And we pray for many, many more with our family. Oh, look, huh?
Hi, my name is Dorothy Jean Weathers Ford. I'm a descendant of Lola Mae Weathers, who is the baby daughter of the original 13. And my mama was the baby, young, quiet, meek, humble person. And she has 10 children, who she reared up with my father. His name is M.C. Weathers. These are my two sisters, Charlotte and Victoria.
Hello.
Hi. we're just so proud to be a member of the Thompson family, you know, reared up with the Thompson family. And my mother, she went to church all the time. They brought her up in church, and she brought us to church, taught us about the Lord, and, you know. Like I said, she was a very humble, quiet person. Never talked in immersion, but what she said, it stuck. It stuck with us, you know.
It did.
Okay, like Dorothy said, we are the descendants of Lola Weathers, and we are sisters, and we love each other, We are so glad to participate in this family reunion. There's so much love out here today. And there's nothing like family. I say family that prays together stays together. And I hope everything continues to go in loving and spirit in here. I feel the love in here. I feel the joy in here. And I love my family. And thank you so much.
Amen.
The Thompson family has been exciting and crazy and a lot of dysfunction, but we all love each other. We're all close and tight-knit, and no matter what we go through, we always come back together at the end of the day and love one another.
Hello, I am proud to introduce you to the children of Odie and Josie Nell Thompson Moore. My name is Jolynis Moore Turner. I am the oldest girl in the family.
My name is Odie Moore. I'm the eldest of the family.
My name is Bernadette Moore.
My name is Jessica Moore.
My name is Odie Moore.
And you would think that this was all of their children, but you would be wrong. 8 of them are missing. I'm going to name them in absentia. That means they're not here, they're absent. The very first one is Merrick Anthony Moore. The next one is Lawrence Lawrence Dudley Moore. Stanley David Moore. Wayne Paul Moore. Quentin Delaney Moore. William Craig Moore. Janelle Moore Kirkendall. And Lance Sigmund Moore.
And he's the baby.
And he is the baby. And you see, it's a lot of us. It is a lot of us. That's why it's hard to keep us all in order. But my mother was able to do that. My mother knew each one of her children. She knew our personalities. And she loved us all the same, even though we were quite different. Each of us have our own talents that comes from my mom. We love our mother. We miss our mom. My talent would be the gift from my mom of speaking. My mother was a great orator. A great orator.
My talent would be singing. My mother was a great singer.
What would your talent be?
My talent was organizing. My
mother was a
great orator.
What would your talent be, Laura?
Jackie. And Odie, what would your talent be?
I coach little children.
My mother was also a coach of sorts. She was a Girl Scout leader. So you see, we are a combination of everything that my mother was.
Great job, y'all.
I'm David Thompson
White. I'm Linda Thompson Young. And we're the descendants of Woodrow Thompson, better known as Uncle Rasco. I'm the youngest of 14 children. And our dad passed away at the age of 80 years old. He was a very serious man about his garden and his yard work. And he loved the Greater Livingston Church. And he always made sure that I got up and go. We have Willie Bell, Coma, that's the oldest girl. Then we have Clement Thompson, we call him Polk. And we have W.B. Thompson, everybody know him as Monroe. And then there's Cleveland. We just call him Clee. And we have Charles and Woodrow Jr. And we have our brothers Sammy Thompson and Leon Thompson, which both already have passed away. And there's Margaret Armstrong Thompson and Shirley Thompson and Bessie Thompson. And we all are basically in Mississippi now. except for Woodrow, who lives in North Carolina, and Charles, they live in
Milwaukee, Wisconsin,
yeah. And I can remember as a child, my dad would always make me get up and go to church. And I never understood why, but now I'm so thankful that he did. He gave me a closer walk with the Lord as I grew older. And I just thank God for having a wonderful father. We had a wonderful father. Thank God for it.
He was a very great provider. He always believed in us going to church. And he also loved to sing song at church. He would sing songs and make
music. Yeah, he's a very famous artist around Livingston for the song, "Keep a Little Light Burning, I'm Coming Home."
Hello, good night, everybody. I'm Simone Harris Keys, and I am the granddaughter of Clemmie Thompson and T-Boo Spriggins. Clemmie Thompson Carter and T-Boo Spriggins. These are my offspring. My mother is Johnny Mae Spriggins Harris. And right now I am Simone, Timothy, Thomas Keys III, Symphony, Celeste, and Thomas Keys Jr., my husband. We're excited to be here for the Thompson Family Reunion 2016. We are excited again. We represent Johnny Mae Spriggins Harris in the house.
New Orleans.
New Orleans.
Magwal.
Bossier City.
My name is George Vaughn. I'm the son of Willie Mae Thompson Vaughn, who was the oldest child of Clement and Lola Thompson. There were 13 children, 7 girls and 6 boys. Willie Mae, James, John, Woodrow, and me were the first 5 children. Each one of those children are almost two years apart. James was called Buddy, Willie Mae was called Sister, John was called Flopper, Woodrow was called Rascal, and Al Meeker was called Meese. They lived not far from Livingston Church. By being almost 2 years apart, that meant my mother was old enough to be the youngest child's mother. Of them, the first 5, then next came Leo, Tammy, Alice, Cleo, Josenelle, Beatrice, Robert, and Bill. I missed one, that's Leo. My mother, Aunt Clement was the first of the children to die. My mother was second, Uncle Hammond was third, and then after that, one by one, they dropped out. Of the children, my mother had only one, but the others made up for that one. Between 3 of the family is 45 grandchildren. I'm not gonna say which 3 that was. Mama Lola favorite Buddy. My mother said, everything Uncle James told her, she believed. Last one time, my mother went over to Grandpa Joshua. Uncle John was sick. Mama Lola was having company, and her watermelon got cut. Mama Lola asked who did it, and Uncle James said, John did it. She said, no, John sick. Well, Sister did it. She said, no, Sister don't. So that let her know then that Uncle James was the rascal of the family. My mother, Lola's daddy was named Josh. He married a second time to a lady named Susie Cole. Him and Susie Cole had 5 children. One died young. Yeah, they had Wilson, George, Arlie, and Moe. Wilson lived at Canton, Mississippi. And Wilson got quite a few children. George lived in Chicago, Illinois. He passed there. That's where his family is there. Arlie had one daughter living, and she lived in Jackson, Mississippi. Moe didn't have any children. On the Thompson side, Moe and Sarah had Lucia, Clemmer, Jane, Ora, and Anna, and Sarah. Aunt Anna did not have any children. Uncle James had some, Uncle Lucius had some, and Aunt Sarah had some. Pillman Thompson's mother was named Sarah Johnson. She was kin to quite a few folk. And if you look on the family tree, you'll find some Clancy on Clemens' side. You'll find some Jefferson. You'll find some Lowell, some Ford. And you will find that from Fairview on Old Can Road, the Chinese Road, is where Clemens' people are in between there. But along the way, they done intermarried, and you'll find out that they are everywhere. Of the 13 children, they're scattered in all directions. Lola's people came out of Lee and Scott County. Lola's mother was a member of Harmony Baptist Church. Her husband, Josh, came to Madison County because they got into some trouble with some white people. It was three families that came, the Harrison, the Burks, and the Chandler. They moved into the Canton area. Josh's wife was named Ellen Powell, his wife, and they had four daughters. They had Lucille, Lola, Lucindy, and Ma. Lola had 13 children, Lucinda had one, and Martha had two. One of Martha's sons is a Bennett. His children live over on Catlett Road. Jack, they Martha's oldest son, he had one son, and that son lived in Jackson. And Babe, who was Lucille, her name was Lucille, she changed it to Louise. She had one daughter. Her name was Lovey. She lives in Chicago, Illinois. She's still living. Lovey had three children, two girls and a boy. Bucky was the boy. He was an excellent tailor. Most of you all ought to know the 13 children of Lola and Clement. They are spread from New York City to California. Josh Champion raised his brother's three children. He raised Jesse, Oliver, and Sam Champion was named Jane, but we called him Sam. He raised those three boys along with his first four girls. After the death of Grandma Ellen, he married the Cole lady, Miss Susie Cole. And they had five children. One of them cut his finger off and the doctor was going to take it on off and gave him too much ether and he died. So that left four children. Those four children have children in many areas. And now, do you want to know some secrets of the family? Somewhere along the way, some of those folks got more children than on the record. Okay. One uncle said he got 10, but if you add 2, it'll be 12. Another uncle said he got 15, but if you add 3, it'll be 18. Okay? Scrap was the Robert was the baby boy. Scrap, if you add all his up, they said 10, but you're going to have about 13. So if you count all of us up together, you ought to have somewhere about 120 grandchildren. Now the great grand is too many to count. And great-great-grands is twice as many as great-grands. To learn the Champion family history, you will need to look in Lee and Scott County census records. That way you should find the Champion, Ellen Powell married Josh Champion. Who else you need to know about? Mose Thompson married Sarah Johnson. You got that back. You should have that. Mose Thompson married Sarah Johnson. And they had, I think I named all those children too. Clement and Lola had 13 children. The oldest child was named Willamette. She was born in 1911. They called her either sister or Aunt Bill. The next child was James. He was born somewhere about 1913. They called him Buddy. The next one was Flopper John. His name was John Thompson. Let me back up now. Willamette had one child, James got 10, John got 14. Next come Woodrow. Woodrow had 15 children, and they called him Rasp. The next one was Almisa. She had 10 children. They called her Misa. The next one was Hammond. Leo, his name is Leo. He had 5 children. The next one was Clement, and they called her Bo. She had 3 children. The next one was Alice, and they called her Sleety. She had 8 children. Next was Cleo, and they called him Cuff. He had 12 children. Next was Joseph, and they called her Aunt Jo. She had 16 children. Next was Beatrice, and they called her Aunt B. She had 9 children. Next was Robert. He had 12 children. Called him Scrap. And the last was Lola. They called her Bit. She had 8 children. All of the children, the last one to die was Beatrice. She was the last sibling to die. She and Aunt Sleety died the same year. Uncle Hammy and my mother died the same year. On the Champion side, on Lola's mother's side, Ellen, there were some folks that moved away from Leek County that was related to you. You're going to have some whites. You're going to have some Perry. You're going to have some Perry. And some York. And some those folks came out of Leake County, and all of them moved into the Florida area. Every year, and I don't know why we wouldn't ever carry back, most of the folks that came out of Leake County went to Harmony Missionary Baptist Church at Leake. If you want to know who your folks are, just go to Harmony Missionary Baptist Church at Lena and say you kin to the champion or the white. And you'll see that you got more folks up there than you have down here. E.P. White, daddy was named St. Clair White. St. Clair White and his sister was Lola's mother's first cousin. And nieces. I know some of you might have known Emma Ely and Lucinda Mitchell. Ellen was Emma Ely and Lucinda Mitchell's aunt. So that make you be kin to the Mitchell, the Ely, the White, and you will be kin to some of the York from Leake County. But that's just a tip of the iceberg. In Madison County, Clement Thompson's family line starts at Fairview Baptist Church on Old Cannon Road. And it ends at China Grove CME on 463. You will find people through that area, Kendra Clemens on both his side, his daddy's side, and his mama's side. His mama was a Johnson, and his daddy was a Thompson. And through that area, you will find first cousin, second cousin, double first cousin, double second cousin, because they intermarried with one another. And you will find out that when you say Clinton, you'll find out that some of the Clintons, not only are they first cousins, you'll be first cousin to the wife, Papa Clinton will be first cousin to the wife and to the dad also. So we are from a large family. And after talking, I find out that the Champion family is large as the. And if those of you who want to know something about the Clancy family, it's a lady on Florida Route. Her husband is a king. Her name is Millie. Her husband's name is Jane King. Call her, and she can give you all of the lowdown on the Clancy family. Because her mother married a Clinton. Her grandmother married a Clinton. Her daddy was a Clinton. I hope all of you will take these names down. Go on Ancestry.com. Or when you see somebody and you hear the last name Champion, Powell, Thompson, Clancy, Ford, and all those different names. Please ask somebody who they are so that you can find out your kinfolk. It's sad to have kinfolks that have worked together for 20 and 30 years. I've known one another all of that time and didn't know they were related. I hope you will enjoy this and learn your history. Thank you.
We are richly blessed for this privilege to be here on this occasion.
Yep.
So this is the Holy Ghost headquarters. Keep it that way.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
keep it that way.
Yeah.
And it didn't just start 160 years ago.
Amen.
It started over 300 years ago.
Yeah.
It started in a slave cotton field.
Yeah.
Well, it started before that. I would say there was a church that was snatched out of Africa and transported here and planted into a cotton field.
Yeah.
But you never know what God's going to do.
Yeah.
You know, he can move people to wherever he wants to move them. For whatever purpose. He moved Israel to Babylon.
Yeah, that's right.
But he made a statement there. He says, wherever I have scattered you, he said, I will be with you a little tabernacle.
Yeah.
He said that in Ezekiel. So he was a little tabernacle in this Babylon of Livingston that our forefathers brought to. Being that tabernacle for them, he knew how to deliver them, how to save them. That tabernacle meant a little place of refuge where you can go and rest your weary soul. Your bodies had to work because you were forced to. But they could rest their souls. And as they rest their souls, they was worshiping God with songs. They was praising God because he's that little tabernacle that's going to give their souls rest.
All right.
And once their souls get rested, then they could have the strength to carry on the rest of the day under the pressure. That they did. God watched. He said, I keep my eye on those that are mine. And he did that. And he didn't say for our people to go back to Africa. We didn't have a place to go back to. But that first Babylon over 3,000 years ago, that's when that little church out of Israel was taken into Babylon. He said, I will fix the heart of a certain Cyrus. And he's going to release you. And Cyrus was a heathen. And Cyrus, as soon as he come in, he blessed him to take control over all of the other nations, and they released all of the Israelites, so you can go back home. So he planned that we stay here. He didn't say you're going back to Africa. And he caused us to wait. We don't know why he brought us here, but we see the good that he did. He said all things work together for good. You see, we got the Holy Ghost Church started in that cotton field. They were singing unto the Lord, and you don't know how many was converted while that little church. That one that over 3,000 years ago that went from Israel, there were four members of the church I can think of. And that was Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They stood for their God. They trusted their God. They obeyed their God. And God protected them. Even those in the fiery furnace, God was in there with them. Just as he was with our families in the fields. Under brutal hardship. So they knew God. And this Holy Ghost headquarters, they learned something from their parents. Lord said, pass it on. Isn't that what he told Moses? He said, Moses, you tell your people what I say. Pass it on to your sons, your son's sons. So they won't forget. And then he told them when they were moving around, he says, I think Joshua going through, he said, take these stones and take them and set them over so your children, when they ask, what does this mean? You would tell them what I did. That's a memorial. This church is a memorial. God planted this church here. He planted the people right here in this church. He didn't have us to go back to Africa.
Yeah.
He planted them right here in this church, right in the heart of where they were slaving, where they were working.
Yeah. Yes, Lord.
This community died and became desolate. But this 6 acres didn't.
Amen.
This church never died.
Amen.
This church never became desolate. God gave it to you, and he protected it.
Yeah.
You stayed alive, and you're still the Holy Ghost headquarters.
Yeah.
Keep it up.
Amen.
And God will completely do what he said. He said, I will never leave you nor forsake you.
Yeah. All right. All right.
So he's never left you.
Yeah.
And he never forsaken you.
Yes.
And then he said that not one promise. I think you find that in Kings. Not one promise that he's made ever failed.
Mm-hmm.
So we all gonna stand on God's promise at all times.
Yeah.
Never, never get off his promise. And if he has blessed you with this memorial, this foundation, hold on to it. He gave it to you.
Yeah.
Don't let any money or any offers or any propositions come up to divide you. This is the Holy Ghost headquarters.
Yes.
I see it's going on. It's still alive and well. And so this is the memorial to God. And this is two foundations I see. As a matter of fact, two memorials. A double memorial. The first memorial is to our Lord and Savior. Who blessed us with it. And the next memorial is to our ancestors who withstood everything they went through. And they put their little two bits. You young people may not know what I'm talking about. You remember in the old time we said 2 bits, 4 bits, 6 bits?
Yeah.
All right. They put those little 2 bits together. It took a lot of them. Their plantation was full of them.
Yeah.
And so they didn't have any money.
Right.
They took their little 2 bits, 4 bits, and 6 bits and put it together and got enough money to make $60 and bought this place. And when they bought this place, God has kept this place and kept it growing, growing mightily spiritually.
Yeah, all right.
And so this is a double memorial, the memorial to our family who was steadfast in the faith.
Yeah, all right.
And a dedication to God who gave them the courage to do it.
Yeah.
And then this is a double foundation.
Yeah.
You living and moving on the foundation you talk about, that we say the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And he says in Ephesians 2:20, that the foundations are built on the apostles and the prophets. And so I see you still speaking the apostles and the prophets' words.
Amen.
Stay with that foundation.
Amen.
As long as you stay on the foundation of God's word, it was Jesus Christ.
Yes.
You'll never fail.
Amen.
Never fail. Stay on that foundation. And the other foundation is this ground that God bought for you. That's the double foundation and the double memorial. And we thank God for you. So we are rich, richly blessed to be here.
I
have learned so much from my mom, yet this is my first church. I was born 98 years ago. In my first church, and here at this church, it wasn't right here, it was up there where those cedar trees are. My first church is where I sang my first solo, and my sister and I sang our first duet. We were small, I guess I was about 4. And she's about 5 or 3 and 4, whatever our age was. I don't think our diction was so good. We didn't enunciate our words well.
All right.
But Professor Parker, Reverend Parker,
yeah.
His sister, Carrie Parker, she was my teacher, and the whole church, they didn't understand what we say. Oh, but we got such a standing ovation. And many, many hugs and kisses.
Amen.
And felt richly blessed. This is the church, my first church in my first school.
Yep.
My mom's first church in her school.
Yep.
My grandmother's first church in her school.
Yep.
My great-grandmom's first church in her school.
Yep.
The great-grandma was born right over there.
Yep.
Where Mr. Graves lived. Because her mother apparently was working in the household of that family there.
Yep.
Her mother was born in 1822. Lucy was working in the house.
Yep.
And she and her husband was having their family. She was married to Tom Nolan. She was Lucy Clark. And in working in the house, and they perhaps had shortly married, and so had Arnie Graves, shortly married Sarah Lowe. And they were having their children around the same time. And two of her children was born around the time two of my great-great-grandmom's children were born, and she had to breastfeed those babies were her baby.
Yeah.
So, therefore, everywhere I walked around in this area, it was a 10,000 acre area, and we were on the 2,000 plot that was over there where Elmo Graves lived.
Yeah.
That's the plot we were on. The others are New Hope, and it's four others. I can't name them all. And I got the slave sheet, and there's my parents, my great-grandma, my great-great-grandma's name on it. And they helped buy this church.
Yeah, yeah.
So I got six generations that are in this church.
All right.
I can't find that oldest one, but her children was here.
Yeah.
Because they on that slave sheet where they was released, saying that they were born 1861 or 1857. The census say 57, the slave sheet say 61. So therefore, I have a rich heritage right here in this church, and I'm the fifth generation. And my mom loved the church so much because her whole family came out of it. And she talked about it so much that we had to love it. And so this is a memorial day for me and a joy for me to see that God has kept his promise. He's never left, and nor will he leave us as long as we stay with him. Amen. And then we see here that on this visible foundation, and I'm seeing how you are busy, busy for the Lord. And I heard the minister, the pastor singing about, I give myself over.
Yeah, yeah.
That is my constant thought. I'm thinking of Romans, the 12th chapter, the first two verses. What does the Lord say there? Yourself, a living sacrifice. That is my life. That is my life. Mm-hmm. And I offer myself to God every day, complete, that he use me until he use me up.
Yeah.
And I don't want to stop going until he announces the time that I must stop.
Yeah.
And so I want to keep that song in mind for everybody. Offer yourself to the Lord continuously.
Yep.
You will never regret it.
Amen.
And you will enjoy your journey no matter what.
Yeah.
Because you know who's behind you.
Yes.
You know who's behind you. He's got your back.
Yes.
I just enjoy, I would take nothing for my journey.
Yeah.
I would take nothing for it. And I feel so blessed to be invited to come and talk about these things. And I see Livingston, I would say over 150 years ago, maybe that 160. God planted this church here as a lighthouse. When the community died out, this lighthouse was shining bright.
Yeah, all right, yeah, all right.
And it is still shining bright.
Yeah, uh-huh.
Even when everything around it was desolate, there were no homes. When it was started, we had houses all around because they were tenant houses.
Yeah, yeah.
For the tenants, for the farmers who live on the sharecropper. See, I'm a sharecropper's daughter. And we, the sheep where we were free, I say we, I'm talking about my foreparent, they signed their little X where they were signing off, 1865, July 8th, you see that X. They were signing up to work, continuous on that plantation as sharecroppers.
Yep.
And in their work, they were attending this lighthouse. The rest of the community died out, and the other families left because there were no farms to work anymore. The tractors came in.
Right.
No farms. It died out. But this lighthouse is still shining bright. I call it the lighthouse. And God kept you here, kept you strong, until He decided to send a developer for that hill up there.
Yeah.
He decided the time for that developer. You all were a blessing and still a blessing because you kept the name of this area, Livingston. We call it Livingston.
Yeah.
Nobody may not remember that, huh? Livingston.
Yeah.
You remember that?
Yeah.
We didn't say Livingston, so we got so cute we thought said Livingston.
Yeah.
After we went to school.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I, in my thoughts, I was thinking the gates of hell never, never prevail against it, and can never. And we want, and I was looking at the history here. You have to excuse these all right in your hands. We see the slave farm town of Livingston, Mississippi was incorporated. We see all of that. I guess you all know that. And then how, when it was designated a county seat back there in our slave town, this was an important community. It was the county seat of Madison.
Yeah.
And God let it die. He didn't let you die. He let that community die because that community wasn't right with God.
Yeah.
And so when as I read, I see the names here. I like the name. The names Clement Thompson, Hans Harrelson, Robert Bennett, Lewis Smith, Cornelius Lewis, Solomon, that was Albert Solomon's family, Millers, Walton, that was Charlie Walton's family, Dunk's family, Henderson, Mr. John Henderson, Brown, oh, that was my Miles Brown coming out, that's Minerva's brother, Griffin, that comes out of Charlie and Mr. Jesse Walton. All of these are my kin folks. These are my kin folks.
All right.
Then I see where the Harrises, the Rixes, and the Simmons, and the Websters here, the Champion. My great-grandparent raised my mom. My mom was raised by slaves. Her mother died. My mom was born in 1903. Her mother died in 1906. And this three-year-old baby was placed in her grandmother's and grandfather's care. They were already senior citizens, born in slaves, and the great-grandmother, born in 1822, helped to raise her. They taught her all about the history of the whole place. And she could remember, they didn't teach it to her, but they made a little missionary out of her. Grandma Mahalia, she would go to help the sick people in the community, and my mom was 3 years old, and there were no babysitters. And there were no daycare centers in those years, in 1906. So therefore, she had to take this little baby with her. Then while those older people was talking, she was absorbing all of that knowledge. But she didn't know she was gathering history. And she never talked about it until she found loneliness in her life when my dad died. And she just wanted to start talking about her life. And so I decided I'm just going to listen to kind of make her feel good. Then I realized it was history. I said, let me start writing. So therefore, I got more history just listening to her.
Yep.
And I thank God that I did listen. And when I see that, and I see what they did, and I see all of these people's names, then I saw my first teacher, my first teacher's sister. I don't know if Miss Carrie Parker was Reverend Parker's wife or sister, but she was my first teacher. And then being my first teacher, whenever she was sick, then Reverend Parker was coming and he'd teach us. Here he is, Reverend P.F. Parker.
Yeah.
These are people I know. And they had a major part in my life in the earliest part of my years. And those are the formative years. And I thank God for that. And they have such a rich history, I cannot cover all of it. It's so much.
Amen.
It's so much. But it's such a rich history.
Yes.
Amen.
And I just want you all to feel blessed.
My Lord.
Feel blessed in the Lord, knowing that before these 6 acres was given to you, this Holy Ghost Spirit was already
Amen.
Here.
Amen.
In the cotton field.
Yeah.
In the cotton field.